activists who found themselves.
Some may have thought that getting the U.S. State Department to ban the entry of Philippine officials involved in the detention of Philippine Senator Leila de Lima was already a big win for U.S. Senators Dick Durbin, Patrick Leahy, and Ed Markey. On Wednesday, the trio in the U.S. Senate showed they were not yet done. In a privileged speech on the Senate floor, Senator Durbin talked about what became a tit-for-tat with the Philippine government.
The president of the Philippines, President Duterte, announced that he was banning Senator Patrick Leahy of Vermont, as well as myself and Senator Ed Markey of Massachusetts, from ever visiting the Philippines. I was kind of shocked to see that. I didn't expect it.
Senator Durbin explained to his colleagues how the words of a known Duterte critic pushed him to call for her release.
Let me read an excerpt from a letter she sent me. As you can imagine, I may be the one currently in detention, but I'm not the only victim suffering in this situation. So are the victims of extrajudicial killings and their families. So are all defenders of human rights. And ultimately, so are all of us all over the world who defend democracy and the rule of law.
Durbin insisted on de Lima's immediate release from what he regarded as political incarceration, or at least give her a fair shot in court.
Assure a quick and credible trial for Senator de Lima.
Shortly after Durbin's speech, the Senate passed Resolution 142, condemning the government of the Philippines for its continued detention of Senator de Lima and the alleged harassment of another Duterte critic, Fil-Am journalist Maria Ressa. The resolution calls on President Donald Trump to impose sanctions on Philippine government officials who are supposedly behind the detention of Senator de Lima. The said resolution, first introduced by Senator Markey back in April 2019, is not binding in law, but expresses the collective sentiment of the Senate. Meanwhile, a separate resolution is pending in the U.S. House of Representatives, introduced by six lawmakers and sponsored by California Congresswoman Jackie Speier. House Resolution 233 also condemns de Lima's imprisonment and calls for the Philippine government to release her. As for Senator Durbin, he insisted that all of these efforts play a big role in shaping the future of U.S.-Philippine relations.
In the end, her freedom and the end of government harassment of journalists like Maria Ressa will be important tests of whether cherished democratic norms we share with our longstanding Filipino allies will be respected by President Duterte.
Ultimately, for Durbin, this will cement America's image as a champion of human rights and democracy around the world. TJ Manatok, ABS-CBN News. Personalities toward the president.
For what purpose does the gentleman from New York seek recognition? Mr. Speaker.